Hi, everyone, and welcome to this next module in the Inclusive Education Paraprofessional Training Series. This module is entitled Specialized Instruction for the Inclusive Classroom with a focus on math. So our objectives will be to understand what specifically specially designed instruction, SDI, looks like in practice for math, and how to know to create curricular modifications in math, how to apply SDI in math content. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna go through math modifications and a curriculum example, just like the ELA example on the previous module. So just as a reminder, you have this paraprofessionals roles and responsibilities resource. You can link to that. It's the PDF of the PowerPoint presentation. And we'll be focusing on how to increase active participation for students with disabilities in inclusive classrooms, and how to provide direct instruction, specifically supporting making modifications to embed students' IEP goals in the modifications that we're making. So similar format as the ELA module, there are many different math modifications that you can make depending on what your student is good at and what they need with their IEP, and including using some web-based supports through things like MobiMax or IXL Math. So collaborate with your teacher and see what might work, what works best for your student. So some math modification examples are from some of my students at Rowan University. So when they were talking about this image on the top left, when they were talking about teaching money, which you may or may not want to teach depending on your student, you might just teach them to use an ATM card, Venmo, Apple Pay. But you know, if students would benefit from learning money, what this modification is just lining up this image here, 125 plus 255, you know, so lining up so that the decimals are aligned, creating little mini visuals of dollar bills and different size coins, you know, putting things together to show how, you know, $3 bills equals $3, you know, three quarters equals 75 cents, things of that nature. Another student, the image on the top right, for simple math equations like 2 plus 3 equals 5, they just put two images to represent the number 2 and put a border around it, meaning very clearly these two balls mean two things. And then the three balls here means three things, and then equals 5 balls. So making things visual, giving clear boundaries is a nice math modification. And then another student made a modification here with directions of how to do long multiplication, and then set it up in an Excel spreadsheet with color-coded cells. So these are things to be thinking about. And then they specifically use a universal design for learning approach. So ways to make things accessible. And it would be very easy to do this sort of thing fairly quickly in a math class or when the teacher is teaching math. So then an example here is second grade math IEP goal. So this would be something that you're responsible for doing. You're responsible for implementing IEP goals. So by the end of the 2021-2022 school year, when given a series of two-digit addition problems within 100, the student will correctly complete 7 out of 10 problems independently on 8 out of 10 opportunities as measured by teacher-prepared tests. And then this link here will take you to the grade level standard that this is connected to in New Jersey. So again, like our ELA example in the previous module, this is a very common math curriculum in this region in New Jersey, McGraw-Hill MyMath. And this is a second grade example to connect with that second grade IEP goal. So again, here is the IEP goal. It's a series of two-digit problems with 100. And so one idea is to create vocabulary flashcards, right? So giving some more visuals, giving some practice and like review of what this is before the student starts to do some of that work. Using real objects or manipulatives so that it's very concrete, very hands-on, right? So that math has a good way to really provide interactive stuff for students to engage with. You might add fact family worksheets as appropriate for the student so that they're engaging in different concepts of math, different formations of numbers, and that sort of thing. The fourth idea is using a place value for visuals. So again, having some sort of visual reference point, you know, so that they can interact with it and kind of break down numbers, deconstruct numbers in a place value chart, something of those of that nature. And that, again, this is good for English language learners and other students in the class, giving more visual supports. And students can choose to use them if they find them useful. And the use of a calculator is a very simple idea, right? So instead of having to do the computations long way, provide a calculator. Maybe you have them solve a few problems, paper and pencil, and then you have them check their work with the calculator, things like that. And if the classroom is doing, four digit by four digits, addition, your modification would be aligning with the IEP goal to two digit by two digit addition, right? As long as that's where the student is at. If the student is further along, you wanna be providing modifications that are at the student's level. So just like the ELA module, the deeper dive activity here is to make a math modification with your modification bag. So here's an example of fourth grade math. If you click it on this link here, it'll take you to a Google Doc where you'll see this fourth grade math worksheet. And then you're going to use your modification bag and make 3 to 5 on the fly or reactive modifications based on the worksheet. And like I said, giving students a bunch of worksheets to complete is not always best practice, right? But we want that happens sometimes, and that's the reality of schools sometimes. And we want to be able to make this accessible in many ways. Okay. So the summary of our ideas here. Just like ELA, math problems or math modifications can be reactive and on the fly to adapt to the changes of the classroom, or proactive and planned out ahead of time. And the goal here is to have proactive modifications prepared as often as possible. So planning with your teacher, maybe the grade level teams, and making sure that you know what's coming up, get into a routine of getting materials ahead of time so you can make as many proactive modifications as possible based on the student that you're supporting in their IEP. And becoming fluent in how to make both proactive and reactive modifications is important for your job as a paraprofessional to effectively support all students in an inclusive classroom, and not just students with disabilities, but all students that you're interacting with. If your student is that you're supporting has appropriate access, then get them started and you can work with lots of other kids. Here are some references should you want to take a deeper dive here. And these are some image credits. And thank you for your attention to this. And thank you to the LRC South for supporting the development of this content. I hope this is helpful.